So hello students, I welcome you all on this YouTube channel. Today we will discuss potentiometer as an error detector. So here you can see the rotary potentiometer, right? See this, it is in circular form like this. So these are the two dials, right? There's a knob and you rotate the knob and you can see the angular positions, right? Theta r and theta naught. So error detectors are used to measure, or you can say they are used to sense the error signal in control system. This error is basically the difference between the actual magnitude of the output and the desired output. So error is the difference between these two, right? So the magnitude of the desired output is constant, right? It is input and is called as reference. So theta r is denoting this, right? So now to control the position of the shaft, the error is to be determined, right? So this error is nothing but the angular difference between position of the input reference, right, and input reference and the output shaft, right? Input reference shaft and the output shaft, right? So, and this is expressed in degrees or in radian. So a potentiometer error detector measures this error, that means the difference between this reference angular position and the output desired position, right? So it will, the potentiometer error detector, it will measure this error and convert this into proportional voltages, right? So here you can see this is the output that has been tapped from here, right? So here this error E is proportional to difference in angular position, that means theta r and theta naught, right? So theta r and theta naught, you can write it error theta E, right? So when you remove this proportionality, you will get the proportionality constant Ke. So Ke theta r minus theta naught is equal to Ke theta E, right? So Es is equal to Ke theta Es, right? When you take Laplace, you can write error Es is equal to Ke into theta S. So this Ke is the proportionality constant, which is volts per radian. So here, when you rotate, when you rotate these two knobs at the same position, right, that means at the same angular position, when you rotate these two knobs, then both will be at same potential, because you are rotating and keeping these two knobs at the same angular position. That means the angular difference between these two is zero. So that's why the potential difference in that condition will be zero across these two terminals, right? But when you rotate this knob, second knob, right, suppose in clockwise direction, right, keeping this reference knob fixed, then you can see potential, the angular difference, right, angular difference, and this angular difference will be corresponding, will be converted into the potential difference appearing, which is appearing across multimeter that can be measured, right? So this can be measured, the potential difference can be measured across potentiometer, right? So multimeter gives the reading of potential difference, right? So if you rotate, but now if you rotate this second knob, suppose in anti-clockwise direction, then you can see the negative reading, right? Means error is in negative direction, right? So when there is any difference, when there is any difference between theta r and theta naught, that means when there is any angular difference, then you will get an error. So this error is theta e, right? And we will get this error, and this error is detected by this potentiometer error detector, and it will convert this error into equivalent voltages, right? So this error is detected in form of voltages, right? This error is detected in form of voltages, so which can be measured using multimeter, right? So if you want to control the position of the shaft, right, the error needs to be determined, right? And for that, this potentiometer error detector can be applied, right? So you understand now what is potentiometer error detector? So potentiometer error detector is basically it measures the error and convert it into proportional voltages, right? So to control the position of the shaft, the error is to be determined, and it is nothing but the angular difference in the position of these two angles, theta r and theta naught, right, is converted in form of voltages using this error detector potentiometer, right? So this is basically rotary potentiometer, right? This is not a linear potentiometer, all right? So now if you see from here, you can calculate Ke. If you find, you will get transfer function Ke is equal to Es divided by theta Es, right? You will get this, okay? So if you want to make the block diagram, then you can draw this. Here it is coming, see, this is the reference signal theta S, reference angular position, and this is the theta naught or theta output, you can say this, right? So here you will get this, and this is the error basically, which is theta E. In Laplace domain you can write theta ES, right? So theta ES is nothing but the difference between theta R and theta naught, right? And here this is the transfer function KE, right, which is ES by theta naught theta ES, right? So this is the block diagram representation, right? So this is, you can write theta error, right, ES error signal. So KE is output ES divided by theta ES. So this is the block diagram that you can represent, right? This is the block diagram. You understand? So this error theta E is the difference between theta R and theta naught, right? And when you calculate the transfer function, this KE is equal to ES divided by theta ES. All right? So you understand now? Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.